Hari mau buka dulu, Pak Wisnu mau buka dulu, atau langsung saya?
Langsung ya, langsung nggak apa-apa.
Langsung.
Langsung, baik.
Ya, mungkin aja kalau gitu ya. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hello everyone. Thank you for joining our event on enhancing research experience through to ejective EBBS 2021 organized by Fasilkom UI Research Month. Last year we have conducted the first program, and this year we are conducting the second batch programs of enhancing research experience starting last month, March, and end of this until end of this month, April. So last week we have conducted several events. For today's sessions, we have a speaker, Dr. Wahyu Kaisarendra. He is diaspora scientist visitation. He will deliver talk on writing academic paper for journal publications, tips and tricks. He is from University of Brunei Darussalam. My name is Kurnia Ningsih. I will serve as a moderator for today's session. So let me introduce speakers today. Dr. Wahyu Kaisarendra currently as an assistant professor of General Engineering, Faculty of Integrated Technologies, University of Brunei Darussalam. He obtained Bachelor Engineering Hons from Mechanical Engineering, Diponegoro University, Indonesia in 2005. He obtained Master of Engineering Hons at Mechanical Design Engineering from Pukyong National University of Korea in 2010, and he obtained his PhD at Mechanical Engineering from University of Wollongong, Australia in 2015. He was research coordinator at Faculty of Integrated Technology, University Brunei Darussalam in 2020. He was also academic editor, Journal of Shock and Vibration, Hindawi, Q2, with impact factor 1.628 for 2 years, 2019 until 2020. He was also guest editor in Symmetry Journal at MTPI for last 2 years, 2019 until 20. He is currently Deputy Managing Director for Southeast Asian Region, International Indonesian Scholar Association, or Ikatan Ilmuwan Indonesia International, IPOR, since 2020 until 2022. He already published several output, number of papers in international journals, 55, and he already published 25 conference papers and 3 book chapters and also 2 patents. So welcome to all participants online via Zoom and YouTube today, and you may interact with the speakers by writing your comments or questions through Q&A box. Okay, thank you for the introduction. Now it's time for Dr. Wahyu Kaisarendra to deliver talk. Dr. Wahyu, time is yours.
Okay, thank you very much, Dr. Kurnia Ningsih. I think first of all, I would like to say good morning to everyone, and also I would like to thank to Professor Wisnu Sasmito for inviting me for this prestigious or honorable event. Also, I would like to thank to Dr. Hari Budi Santoso for this chance, very good chance for me to share my experience during more than 10 years being a writer and also reviewer and also editors of journals. So yeah, I think I would just like to avoid a delay, I would like to start to just reading the top title today, writing academic papers for journal publications, tips and tricks. In this title, I don't want to like other speaker that like mention about SQ1 or S-star. I just would like to target that all participants today can have like a knowledge, because we have to start with the good motivation, and we start with the from the step by step, not just to jump to like a very high impact or maybe SQ1 journal. But soon, if you have some training, you will have a chance to publish in a very high impact factor journal. And also, I'd like to share my tips and tricks according to my self experience as a writer, reviewers, as well as a editor in journals. I think yeah. Thank you very much for the reading my CV, Dr. Kurnianingsih. But I would like to highlight that this is the my research interest. If anyone coming today, maybe we have a same background or same research interest, we can collaborate in the future. We'll be happy to help in this research, like a product design, mechatronics, robotics, mechanical engineering, digital manufacturing, machine learning, and deep learning, also IoT and signal processing, and also currently, I also serve as a journal editors for still going in shock and vibrations journals, and also several guest editor in sensors journal, MDPI, micro message MDPI, as well as symmetry. So I would like to just sharing my experience today, and I think we better start with the motivation, because without motivation we cannot do anything that any target. So you need to have motivation. So according to my experience, maybe this is the motivation that you have to publish a journal, publish a paper in a journal. So maybe you have to benchmark of research quality, and you can have also to share the knowledge or knowledge dissemination. You can also branding or international reference. Of course, if you are a lecturer, you would like to have like career promotion, or maybe in some of the university also already applied incentive. Also the last reason or motivation to publish a paper in journal international is maybe you can have research product commercialization. Maybe this is the one that I would like now, I would like to target, because I have already papers that now I would like to apply all my theories to have like patents or commercialization. So I think also I would like to have some quotes. Today's quote is, a good football commentator is a former football player. Maybe most of the participants will agree with this quote, because without experience, we cannot have any information. So better you start or you try by yourself, and then you will have some own experience. So this, and also I would like to be different with others. Yeah, I have been attending a lot of seminar in terms of writing journal publication, and most of them like they just speak in like their own point of view. If you are beginner, maybe some of the person today is very beginners. If you have look very high to the expert speakers, you will feel like demotivated. Why? Because for example, just reading about the edge index. Oh, the speaker maybe for example has a 20 or 25 edge index. Maybe me or maybe some of us has only like a 5 or 3. So it will be demotivated to the beginner. So better for the good speaker for the writing or publication, we need to have a point of view from the beginners, not from the expert. So this is the one that I would like to deliver in today's presentation. Hopefully will be useful for all participants, because I have 2 points here. beginners need to have a benchmark by learning from the expert. This is good. This is correct. Just to build motivation and to obtain their shared experience, not like to see like their achievement. There will be like a different. So you just get motivation from them. Maybe in the future will be at least same level with them. And also the good expert, in my point of view, should be able to teach beginner from their beginner point of view, not for the expert point of view, because we have already different point of view. Yeah, hopefully will be helpful. And also I would like to share also that if I compare with others speaker, that they always saw that successful story. Actually, behind their successful story, we have unsuccessful story, like the one that I present here. You can imagine in one journal, if you make an account, for example, in Elsevier, in my case is measurement Elsevier. If you have account, you have to submit your paper through this account, and then your history will be remain in the website. So in this case, you can imagine with my experience, I have like a 80% rejection rate among 5 papers that have been submitted to the measurement journals. Only one is successful. So I would like to encourage the beginners. I would like to give motivation that's the behind the successful story of the expert, we have unsuccessful story. So this is the example. So I would like to also highlight that if you never try, you will never get the experience. So you can better start from now. And okay, and then I would like also to maybe some of you that still also start to publish, you have no idea what the types of journals. Actually, we have like in Elsevier, I would take a sample that we have 1, 2, 3, and 4. Yeah, we have research paper. I will show you later on what is the research paper, and also we have review article, we have short communication, and also. And the last, we have letter to the editor. This 4 is the types of journal papers typically has in Elsevier's journals. So alhamdulillah, and I have been tried for this all. I have also have risk papers. I also have review article already published, and also short communication and letter to the editor. We will have a look maybe step by step. And for MBBI also, we have 3 basic types of the journal papers: article, review, and communication. And this also some tricks that, because I will say that the tricks is maybe your paper is suitable for article, or your paper is suitable for the review, or your paper is your draft suitable for communication. We can later on discuss about this. And this example of the article, I think most of the lecturer or researcher would like to publish in a normal article draft. This is an example. Usually the normal article has like, for example, in my opinion, is like have a 10 to 25 pages. Yeah, if you have, and also it has experiment, data analytics, and discussion. This is the normal. I think this is the normal. The papers you are already experienced, and review papers, for example, this also if you have no data or if you have no like experience yet, we can start with the review papers, because if you compare the citation rate, I published this paper in 2018, few is many, 2000 already, but the cited people only cited 5 times of my paper. If you would like to take as an advantage for the citation, you can also, if you already feel that you are capable enough to write a review paper, because we have already like a comprehensive knowledge in particular area, you can start to have review papers. Review papers usually has a lot of citation rate. You can imagine from it, like 4 years, I have like a 1,000 plus citation rate, also few by like a 5,000 something. So the review paper usually consists of like a 20 to 50 pages, long in the paper pages, and usually typically we have to write, we have to cite it, or we have to review at least like 50 to 100 papers. So you can start, yeah, maybe for those of you that maybe still waiting for the data, but you have, I think you learn already many papers you have read, so you can start with the review paper. It's no, there is no, yeah, I think you can, because there is some, in my experience, there is some different. Last time, the review paper is only for professor, maybe like a professor Wisnu. He already suitable to write a paper, a review paper, because he, I think, in my opinion, he has a very solid background in his particular research. And sometimes also editors in high impact journal or journal will invite him to to submit a paper in term of the review papers. But currently, so far, like in the recent, like 3 years back or 5 years back, anyone can write a review paper as long as the review paper is very comprehensive and complete. So this the so why we don't take this advantage. So you can try to write down a review papers. And this is also trick trick for, I will also give you a trick in the beginning for that, but I also have a different session for the trick and tips as paper slides. So this is the I also recently supervise or help the some of the industrial people in Indonesia, PT Indonesia Power, to write a papers because they have a lot of data, but because they are coming from the industrial practice people, they have no idea how to start in writing a papers. So in the last 6 months, I helped some of the PT Indonesia Power staff to publish, because so one at the moment, one of the their KPI, key performance indicator, to get the promotion, to get incentive, also publication in journal or conference. And when I first time being supervised for them, they're good. They have a lot of data, very nice data, very complete, because industrial practice. But the way they write a paper is a bit need improvement. So I'm trying to submit in communication paper. Usually communication is a bit less strict compared to the normal article, because as a reviewer, maybe you can also try as a reviewer. If you are a reviewer, you have a mode. If you receive review papers, you have your mode maybe this high. And if you have a, like a accepted article, normal article, you maybe will get lesser the maybe marking or assessment. And if you also receive a communication paper, that because communication paper usually only consists of 5 to 15 pages, and the analysis is not too deep. So as a reviewer, you must going down a little bit your assessment, because you cannot apply your assessment to all paper types. It's not fair. So that's why I can say that if you sub, if you have like have no enough analysis result and description, but you think that your result is has a novelty or new, you can submit to communication paper, because it's less pages. It's like about 5 to 15. So you can have a look how communication paper looks like. You can from this example, already published in Sensors Journal, MDPI, Q1. And okay, I'll try to start with the steps. First, I would like to adapted from the Elsevier. Elsevier has 10 typical questions for the writers or the, for the authors, but I just would like to pick some of them. Question number 2 is, I think, relevant with our discussion today. So usually question number 2 is asking about what is a reviewer looking for. Yeah, you can try, if you have invitation as reviewer, you can have, you need to also accept, try to be a reviewer. Then you will see that, you will know that how or what is a reviewer looking for. Usually reviewer will looking at three main or general scope, the different thing. First of all, reviewer see whether the paper is within the scope of the journal. Yes, I think most of you already know. We need to submit a journal with part in particular scope, the scope will be have to be matched. And number 2, we have science contribution. We have contribution in the in particular science or the particular research or topic. And number two is you need also to have like a paper must need meets the conceptual novelty or standard. Yeah, this is the three of the answer from the Elsevier. And this is the example of the mismatch scope. Recently, we have submitted for this. Alhamdulillah that I get the sub example. This example that I submitted to the wrong scope. My paper is about the robotics control, but I submitted to the journal that has like in mechanical trouble deformation stresses and thermodynamics. So you will receive this kind of the email. So the journal editor will write an email to you that mentioning that we will not able to process your papers because the paper maybe you can see from here different. Yeah, I think not implicitly mentioned, but I can understand that this is because of the scope of the journal and the scope of the paper journal paper is not matched. So this example. And question number four, I think also as a supervisor for a number of the authors recently in the last 5 years, I have been also supervise my colleagues in Indonesia. So number four is suitable, I think, for those who English is not the first language. Also applicable for me because our English, maybe Indonesian is not, we use Indonesian, English is not our first language. So will that affect my chances of publishing? You can see this reason or this answer. If they are flawed in the language of the paper, but the editor sees there is a good science, then your paper will still make it into the review process. So don't worry, don't be demotivated about your writing. So you can start writing everything as long as you have a very great contribution in the science or in the particular area. As reviewer, we will still consider your paper. However, at the end of the submission process, you also will ask to address or to improve your English, or the editor also the FL also can suggest you to find the native English speakers to proofread your papers. Okay. And example tips number two from Nature's nature.com. Also get from this website. How to get published in high impact journal, big research and better writing. Research has, Nature has maybe four, if I'm not mistaken, four tips to be a good writer or authors. Number one is you have to imagine that your research is telling a story. So start by asking a big question. You can start by asking a big question and form a logical argument. High impact papers need strong evidence and not what you concern is the reason. Look to fill as many gaps in your story as possible with research builds up and world picture of a system. Papers will tell a clear, compelling story and be written with a chosen scientific publication in mind. Okay, if you have difficulty to understand, I will have some easy example. So maybe I would like to start, I would like to bring you to the, maybe if you have try IELTS test. IELTS test is one English test that consists of the writing. Yeah. If you have tried English IELTS test, this is a very good example for the as a writing because you given one graphs or figure. Imagine that this is your result. So because of the Nature suggests us to imagine our research as a telling story, you need to write down as many as words, as many as sentence according to the figure that you have obtained from your analysis or from your simulation or from your experiment. So the good writers, yeah, maybe I tried this before I have experience in the writing. Maybe as a beginner in my experience, I only can write like a two or three sentences. For example, this graph is mentioned, discussed about the grams in quantity in 6 years period. Also, we have three comparison. That's it. But actually, different people will have different writing method. So for example, this is a good one. So you can see from here, maybe I will share also this PPT because I need to stick with the time. You can learn maybe in your free time that how can this figure or this script can have 1, 2, 3, 4 page paragraph. Also, you can imagine very detailed the authors, the writers inform or describe as detailed as possible about this figure. So this is the one that I think nature give you the tips. You have to imagine that your story is your research is a telling story. Okay, number two is about you have to know the audience. The readership for a scientific paper is specialized. Yeah, I think you agree with this because I have in my field is mechanical, so we have a special scientific papers or journals. But you should never assume too much knowledge on readers' part. Okay, imagine that for example in my case mechanical. But I would like in this sentence I would like to describe that although you think that the author, the reviewers or editor is the same field with you, but you need also to describe your result, your paper as detailed as possible. Do not ever assume that they know about your papers. So this is the tips from the nature. This is particularly important in high impression as one of the acceptance criteria in research with broad relevance. Yeah, I found a lot of example that in my students, they think that they just like explain very short, very very brief, and then when I ask why you only describe this result only this only few sentences, and they said I think the editor and reviewer already know doctor about this. Then I give them this example. Please do not assume that the readers or the reviewer or the editor know about your field. So you better this link to the previous tips from nature that you need to imagine that your paper is telling story. You need to describe your result as detailed as possible. But also, do not too long in making like it's a little bit tricky one. In one case, you need to have very detailed explanation, very detailed description. But in another view, you need to have very short, clean, and clear. So this is time to you to learn because you need to have like a combination how to make a detail, but at the same time you also have to make it short, clean, and clear. So I think I can give there's an illustration that the papers usually is don't underestimate the importance of a good title. Or this is also another thing that you need to have a very good title and abstract because you can see from these figures. The title is a very big, has a bigger circle than abstract, and then abstract is in the middle, and actually your paper is very small. So you need to be careful about your title. You need to pick very nice or very good title and abstract. We will have a look how we can create good title and also how can we create a good abstract. Okay, this example of the how can we make a good title. Yeah, this is the one that my prof usually if you writing paper until the final you think I think you have a many iteration. For example, this paper we have like more than 10 or iteration. Reading a good chance the sentence, and this is the first draft. I would like to show you the first draft that I wrote. A title is looks like this. Is very long, a proposed indirect monitoring method based on AWS Amazon Web Services machine learning platform for enabling process in aerospace manufacturing industry towards industry internet of thing. So actually I would like to inform very complete, but you can see this becomes not nice because too long. So then I iterate the title become this title and already published in journal. So you can imagine, you can compare between original title and also the after iteration. We can learn also how to make this title slowly. So this you can see, imagine the same meaning but only consists of only two lines. Another example is about my colleagues in PT Indonesia Power. Also, the first draft he sent me about this, reducing auxiliary power consumption in hydropower plants by modifying the penstock bypass system. I know what he means about this. Then this is not complete enough. Then we can imagine we need to improve. Finally, we come up with this revised title. So yeah, we can learn in my PPT later on because I'm. Okay, the second after title is the abstract. So in the second important things, it should be brief introduction to topic, state the problem that the paper is trying to address, and summarize the main finding, and then give a perspective on possible benefit and utilities of this finding. I give you an example about the abstract. Typically, in my opinion, according to my experience, the abstract should consist of the following content or the information. Number one is you need to state the primary objective of the paper. I give you example, this one. And the second is you need to highlight the merits or contribution of the paper or the research. This also given in the second lines. And next is you need to give a conceptual idea or method on how the contribution is achieved. So this is, I will not go to detail. You can learn slowly during your lesser time. But I give already the example, how the conceptual idea is written. Actually, this is not the final one. I'll try to get the final one that is not maybe missing. But this is okay lah. But I think the some of the samples still need to be improved. Okay. And number four, you need to describe briefly the research design and procedure employed. I also give an example in the blue highlight. And 5 tips that you need to include in your abstract is give the main outcome or result and the conclusions that might be drawn from this data and result. So you can also give some brief result on your abstract, because if you will see also the result of your abstract as your study. And last but not least is include implication or application practice, if any. But actually the last here is not mandatory, but you can add it if any. The important is number one, number two, three, four, and five. So I hope according to this structure, you will be able to create your own abstract. Then this will I give you already the step-by-step how it, because if without the guidance, without this information, nothing, your abstract will be like a mess up. So we need to start with the state of primary objective, highlight the merits, give a conceptual idea, describe briefly the design, as then the last is give the main outcome of the result. Okay, number four from the nature is you need also to make good use of figures. Figures must visually represent your finding. They must be in a logical order and correspond to your story. Okay, and the S, you can read from here, the S of big data figures can become overwhelming, but you can cut them into size. Consider the single subset of data that best describes your point. Okay, I'll try to give some, this is a very funny that I obtained from the phdcomic.com. Yeah, in one view that a picture is worth 1,000 words. Yeah, maybe this is the one that we would like to achieve, but actually a picture with 1,000 words is usually what a PhD. So yeah, you can have own perception which one is better. And then this is too many information here. Okay, we have seen that Elsevier and Nature also already give some tips, and I would like to just sharing my personal tips. Hopefully useful for you. I try also to make it very simple to be understand. My first tip for the writers in Indonesia is you need to read papers as many as possible, in particular research topic, in your own topic, to find the state of the art, to find gaps, and as well as to construct an idea. This is the one that I have done so far before I read a paper. So I read a lot of papers, then you need to get the state of the art to find a gap and construct an idea. Tip number two from me once you have found an idea, you need to start writing immediately. Otherwise, it will be gone. Because yeah, and then yeah, this is my personal experience. That's why I would like to share it. I have tried to keep my idea, and then a few days, and then I find difficulty to get back my idea. So once my tips is, once you have found an idea, you need to start writing immediately. Maybe the meaning of start writing immediately is only like a few sentences that what is your idea. So you need to record in your notebooks or your laptop, because otherwise you'll be gone. And also you need to allocate your time and focus on the idea. Most of the authors in Indonesia that I have supervised is they difficult to find time and focus to the writing paper. So you need to find idea. You need to find the time to write your idea. And number three, you need to you can note all important words, terminologies, sentence, or ideas from the papers with it. So you need to highlight, or you can also I have a trick to write down the. I will show you later on how to do this. These tips. And number four is you need to write something creative. Usually a journal's primary goal is to publish original ideas, and a good journal is interested in submitting new ideas, not in publishing papers that elaborate some existing idea. Okay. Yeah, as a reviewer, I also find many of the sample that they just compare all of the published papers and eight models, and then they make some paper. But actually, comparison is good, but also we need to propose or we need to disseminate our ideas. What is the new from your, what is the contributing in your paper? So you need to highlight about this. And examine the implication of the minor change in assumption. And also before writing, answer the question. Okay, before you write your draft paper, you need to answer your own question about what new ideas you will present or you will provide it, and what result does this paper offer. So maybe only two questions, but these two questions give very huge impact in your paper quality. So do not avoid this. I think the idea don't avoid this tips. And yeah, I'll try to also resume or give some tips about you need to get the reviewer attention earlier, as early as possible, because usually as reviewer they are very busy. If they accept to review your paper, this is like a good for our progress, because if they reject it, otherwise editor will find another reviewer, it will be text time, and then we will long queue and long time for you to be accepted. So better you need to get the reviewer attention as early as possible, because once a reviewer interest with your paper, they will read, they will continue to read your papers. So and then I think there are four I would like to share here is you need to provide evidence of why it is interesting. For example, that is why it should be published. You can provide this information in introduction. I think if you attended the last session by Facilcom, the same event but different speaker by Dr. Mardika Pratama, he already explained in detail about how to write good introduction, and I will not repeat because we already if you would like to get PPT, maybe you can get from the Dr. Kunianingsih. Yeah, he already explained about introduction, how to make a good introduction, and most of referees or reviewers make up their mind at the first bite. Nah, okay. See, they, this is the also some of the, my phrase. Usually I have 15 minutes to read a papers. Please don't think that the reviewer will spend like hours to read your paper. They will just have a look some of the parts about 15 minutes, and then if it's interesting, they will keep first, and then they will read later on. So, but if the referee or reviewer don't like a paper or don't like our paper, they begin to look for reason to justify why the paper should be rejected. Correct. Yeah, to be honest, as reviewer, to reject the paper, I don't need to read full papers. Usually I just read the title, abstract, and then introduction, and then quick view on the result and conclusion. And then when I think that this paper is not suitable for digital publication, I try to get reason to justify my rejection decision. That's why you need to be careful about your paper layout and also paper language, paper content. So, but if the reviewer loses interest from reading the introduction, but his interest in your paper, but he will or he see or he might postpone reading the paper. This is the one that I also usually done. I read after accepted my invitation. I'm not start away read the paper because I have a lot of things to do, a commitment. So I just read first after acceptance of the reviewing invitation. I read the title, and then I read the introduction, I abstract. Then if I'm interested, I will keep later on to read. I will find my own like a time, not in hurry, like enough for like 2 or 3 hours to read. Then we'll give some positive comment or constructive comment. But if I as a reviewer doesn't like, after I accepted the papers and then I read the everything, not suitable, I try to make a decision quick because if you are a bigger reviewer, please do not delay your author because you'll be get maybe they waiting for the PhD graduation, maybe some of them waiting for the any promotion. So if you would like to reject the paper, please do it as soon as possible, like I have done so far. If I don't like the paper, if I don't feel that paper is suitable for journal, I have to find the reason and then submit the rejection letter. But if you would like to accept or you would like to have a minor or major revision, you can find your own time to read the paper in full length. I think this is the my sharing according to reviewers. And number 6, you need also to prepare the manuscript properly. This is the one also this is the most cases that I found from the my colleagues in Indonesia that they did not properly prepare the manuscript according to the journal's layout. So before you write the paper, read the instruction, and use the template. I think this is my tips. And number 7, I think this is also my own tips. Language similar to the Elsevier, language and thesis selection. Don't worry about the language. Don't feel demotivated because as long as you have a good or novel or new idea to be presented in your paper, you can do cosmetic of the language later on. But be sure that during your writing, you need to write complete sentence, not too long, but also not too short. And this is I try to get some of the common mistake. So use commas properly. I think this is to divide the, because sometimes I read that the writer write very long sentence without any comma. So if you would like to reading your paper properly, you need to have comma, then take a break for the reader and then they continue the next sentence. Do not make it very long. So use comma properly and be consistent in the use of tenses. Avoid slang. I will discuss about this later on in detail. Be consistent in the use of tenses, and you need to avoid slangs, colloquialism, and jargons. And use no contraction. This is the tips also. Please do not use the word don't, could not. So you need to avoid using like a do not, could not, and anything that consists of not. So this is the one that use no contraction, and write a reasonably sized paragraph. Yeah. And continue a few words of tenses. This is the one I would like to give some because of some typical question from my college in Indonesia. What is the proper tenses that we can use in our paper. I'm trying to give you some idea. So when you're describing the details of an experiment, that is, for example, what was done before, you can use past tense. I give you the example of the sentence. Acceleration was measured with, okay? So this, I'll repeat again. So when you describe the details of an experiment, because the experiment has been done before in the past time, you need to have a past tense, okay? Point number two, for general truths, or general truths are expressed in the present tense. What are the general truths? Again, see from this example, acceleration is difficult to measure precisely. So if you think that any sentence that lay on or the include in the general truths, you can use, you can express the sentence in the present tense. So for example, acceleration is difficult to measure precisely. And also in as our conclusion, also you can also use a present tense, because you represent the concept at the when you write down the paper. So in the rotor, for example, is the conclusion sentence. In the rotor, maximum acceleration coincides with blah blah blah. So point number two, you can use the present tense in the case of general truths, also in conclusions. Plus, point number three, you can use future tense for what? For the recommendation of maybe future works of your study. For example, I give you example here, example sentence. Modeling this velocity structure will require, maybe you can also give some recommendation in your paper. So you have to use future tense. And continue it for the language. You need to a word on voice or mood. So the passive has been preferred in scientific post. I give you two options. So the passive has passive tense, I think. Passive tense has been preferred in scientific post. But the active voice is more vibrant. You can choose whatever you convenient with, because I also have tried to write a paper in passive form as well as in active voice. So in this sentence, you can also try to understand that. So the passive has been preferred in scientific pose. The active voice is more vibrant, often briefer, and should be used to highlight important facts and to provide variety. If you read the paper, I think you will find the paper only has two types in writing in English. Maybe the authors choose the passive form, or the authors choose the active voice. So if you can also choose. According to these two options, according to your convenience. And okay, this is the one. Maybe this one. Figures, table preparations. This is the common mistake from the beginner. Also, I would like to also highlight. Usually, figures are unclear and not too sharp. And number two, X and Y label, a caption, and units are missing. Number three, figure description is repetitive and poor figure layout. We can have a look at the example. For example, from here, you can just have on perception, because I have received this email from the editor to improve these figures. We provide these figures in the submitted paper, and then once accepted, the editor sent us the email, and they mentioned that the figure in your paper are not very clear. So in that case, before you get this email, I think better you try to provide or to give the very nice figure, then you will not receive any email something like this. And number two is maybe I ask you first before I going on with the answer. Any suggestion for improvement of these figures? Because the figure, what missing here? The missing part is you can see maybe the units as well as the X label and Y label. This is common mistake as well from my colleagues in Indonesia, that they did not provide proper information of the figure. Sometimes they missing the X label, Y label, or also they missing the units of the label X and Y. So in that case, you need to be careful about providing full or detailed information of your figures. And tips again from me, you need to do the blue highlight here, and then please do in my suggestion do not do something like this in your paper when you explaining your figure. I guess sample that, for example, I have a figure one, and the description of figure one is it is found that the measurement was effective is in only 15% of the total duration of measurements as depicted in figure one. This is a good example, and most of my colleagues, when I have a, I become proofreader for the or become a co-authors for their journals, I found many cases like this. So they wrote like a figure one shows that 30%, 35% of the customer choose design one, 15% choose design two, 10% choose design three, and 45% choose design four. This called like a repetition. So we can avoid this kind of the explanation of our figures. We can select the blue one here. Yeah. But again, you need practice, you need time to have this feeling. But that's why I ask you to start immediately, and then you have to practice as many as possible. And this is a sample of my student in UBD. His paper draft for journal. They have one figure in one page and one caption. Maybe you can also have improvement, but I will also share you the good example. Same for me, this is okay, but this can make your pages longer, because you have presented the design or the figure in different figures. How if you present like this? This is my type. You can have like a A, B, C, D, and then you can just have only one figures, and you can explain later on. So figure two has A, B, C, and D. So it will be nicer, looks more nice than the previous one. Yeah, I think this also need to have a practice. You need to have experience about this, because if like this, I can imagine that this has like a four pages, but in here you can have like two pages to strengthen to shorten your paper draft. And number nine from my personal tips is maybe you also have an experience that despite of the paper draft, authors are also requested to submit some additional documents during the submission. Yeah, I think most of you already know that about this, but I think I just like to highlight that this is also important, because sometimes the review would like to see the cover, sometimes also would like to see the highlights and graphic abstract. And I give you example of the cover letter. Actually, there is no guidance what should we include in the cover letter, but in my opinion, this is just like make it summary of your paper, what you offer to the journal or what you offer to the readers. So maybe this layout can be used as a guidance, but do not mean you can have like a, do not use this as the 100% guidance. You can have like modify this example, because they're only example from me. So you need to say dear editor, and then you need to submit a title of your papers, and also you need to confirm that these papers has not been published anywhere or elsewhere, and also is currently under consideration for review process in another journal. So you need to mention, because maybe if you notice that maybe some of the people also do like a misconduct, they submit one paper to different journal. This is something that not good. So we need to submit one draft in one journal until the process done. Then you need, if you get rejection letter, you can withdraw the papers, and then you can submit to another journal. It's okay. And in the body here, you can just have one paragraph to mention that what is your paper about. For example, you present what method you present, and then what experimental you have conducted, and so on. Then it will be submitted together of your paper. Number two is highlight. Yeah, this is the from Elsevier. Yeah, this highlight from Elsevier. In my opinion, the highlight may be not more than 5 points or 5 bullets and not less than 3. So basically, the highlight is between 4 points or 4 bullets and between until 5. So this example also, but this from me example. Maybe you have another. As a reference is okay, but I would like to just give you a sample that the highlight maybe looks like this. So you can just mention what is the method you have proposed and what is the data that you use or collected, and then what is your analysis, and then comparison or discussion, and also you need what is comparison for other methods. This is the example of the highlights. And number three is declaring of competing interest. This is similar. So Elsevier has 3 additional documents. You need also to prepare this document before you submit, because you need to declare that the author have no non-competitive financial interest or personal relationship that could have appeared to influence the work paper is reported in this paper. So these 3 is example from the Elsevier. And if you submit to MDPI, for example, you have this is another one, the graphical abstract. You can see, because MDPI is a open access journal, you can find many examples of the graphical abstract. This is also useful to increase the probability of acceptance, because sometimes also the very super busy reviewer will just read the title and also graphical abstract. So graphical abstract is like the figures that you, your method. If you have chance today, I will just show in my paper later on. Yeah, if we have still a time. Okay, now we move from the tips, because the title is about tips and tricks. I would like to move to the tricks slide from this. Okay, I will start from here. The papers that report experimental works are often structured in chronologically in 5 sections. Yeah, I think this is already a well-known information, but I just would like to inform again that basically the papers will consist of 5 sections. Number one is the introduction. Number two is methods or materials and methods, usually also in my case. And if you have experimental setup, you can have to explain your experimental setup. How do you conduct the experiment? And also, how do you collect the data? And section number 4 is about result and discussion. Some of the authors divide the result and discussion. It's also okay. But for me, because result usually followed by the discussion, I would prefer to put the result and discussion at the same section. This is my style. But I also have seen that some of them also separate result and discussion. And number five is conclusion. So the block here in the middle, we call it like a body of the paper. Okay. The body of the paper, for some cases, like papers reporting something other than experiments, for example, new method or technology, typically have different section in their body, but they include the same introduction and conclusion. Yeah, this is not fixed. If you have research, also maybe you have simulation only without experiment, so maybe this will be slightly different. But basically, the introduction and conclusion will be also similar. And in my opinion, also trick. In my trick, usually before I write down full length paper, my own style is after we create the we have to make a structure of the paper, our own paper. Usually I just, this is to make, to build my motivation, because once you read the also title, usually I write title in the beginning before I have the full paper, because if you create a title and also you start to structure your paper, what will be appear in your structure of the paper, this will give you some motivation to complete the paper. This will give you motivation to finish and to start writing your paper. Yeah, this is my style. So usually my style, I start with the title, and then I start with the structure. For example, how many structures you will have for particular study or research. For example, like introduction, method, experimental setup, result and discussion, and conclusion. And then in between, or in, is there any like a subsection or sub topics for your structure? For example, in method, I provide like what I will present the method that I use, like a CNN for example, and how the CNN structure looks like in our study. And in experimental setup, usually we have like a data a sensor or a data acquisition setup, and also the result of the data you have to present also. And in result discussion, usually very complete and very detailed. So what are result you will present in your paper. So usually this is the type, my style, that usually I construct the paper structure very early in the beginning before I complete the full papers. Yeah, but different people, different style. You can find your own style maybe after you have experience in writing a number of the papers in the future. Also, okay, this also my my tips is you have to do research and writing in parallel. Why? This is very effective in my opinion. There are two types people. Usually some of them is do experiment first or research first, and after that they write a papers. In my case also, I would like to say that the effective way is we have to do the research and we have to writing a paper in parallel or at the same time. Why? Okay, these three point or bullets give you some answer or the idea. Usually, no matter you are PhD student, you are researchers, before you do research, I think most of you will write proposal. Yeah, maybe if I'm okay, if I'm correct, I think you agree with me. So no matter you PhD student or researcher, you have to write a research proposal before you do or you conduct the research. So in proposal, I think you have done the introduction, because in a first journal, paper draft is introduction and literature review. So before you make a paper, you already have introduction from your research proposal. But it's very useful. Yeah, I think then you can just copy and paste from your proposal. Then it's like already you can continue the paper later on. Point number two, the research methodology is a second journal paper draft. The material and method, data collection, design, modeling, simulation, sentence means that once you have created the fixed experiment result, you have to also, or maybe on the at the same time, you can also do partial research, partial experiment. You have to write one section about the research, data collection or methodology. And then after you done your after you have done the experiment everything, then you have time to think what is the result you would like to present or you would like to explain. So this is something that effective in my opinion. You need to do research and writing in a parallel or in the same time. Yeah, as I mentioned before, that Dr. Mahardika Pratama from NTU already provided very detailed information about how to construct introduction. But I would just would like to maybe highlight introduction is usually a good journal paper introduction typically has the following content. Number one is what is the general problem to be solved. are there any existing solutions or methods that has been done previously? If yes, you have to preview those papers, because you need to find what is your improvement from the previous papers, or what is your contribution to add in the gaps. And number three, among the review existing method, which is the best? You have to also not only review as a author or as a researcher, you need to have some decision, or you have to have some opinion among others published paper, what is the best? You need to provide this statement, because without this, reviewer will find that what is your purpose in comparing the previous studies without come up with the information or which the best. And if the best existing method still have limitation, then you have to describe it. Okay, what is the limitation of the existing methods, and this is your gap, and this is your chance to promote or to propose your own idea or your own contribution. What do you hope to achieve or improve from the existing method? Usually, this is very in my as a reviewer point of view, this is very interesting. If I read a paper that the paper proposed or mention about something that can add to the previous method, I would accept this paper although with the major revision. But if I see this kind of the main description in the paper, I will accept the paper even though with the major revision comment. Also in my experience, during the introduction, I think this is new from you, for most of you. If you haven't heard about annotated bibliography, this is also useful if you would like to create introduction, because most of the student that I supervise, also colleagues that I have collaborated with, they just read a paper without take a note. So this will be like a gone. If you read the paper, now you can understand the paper topics as the paper information, but maybe after a few hours later you have to do another or other jobs, and if you would like to refine or go back to the paper, it will be difficult for you to get the information that the paper talk about. So better you have like this method we call annotated bibliography to keep all the information that from the paper that you have read. So definition for those who haven't know about this method, we call an annotated bibliography. It's a list of all information from the article, followed by a brief description of the content, quality, and usefulness of the source. So usually in general, the annotated bibliography should include, number one is the author's names, the title of the article, the names of a source, the data of published article, the page number of the article, plus a brief review of the article. This is the example from the external internet you can find, but I also have own example for you. Hopefully will be useful for you from this example. So this is the paper that I would like to have annotated bibliography from these authors, published in 2009 in Engineering Failure Analysis Journal, Elsevier. I read the papers, full paper link, and then I make this table. My own table is, the journal name is the Engineering Failure Analysis. The publication title is Detecting Natural Crack Initiation, and so on. You can read the authors, is two authors here, and year of publication 2009. What problem or issue is being solved or address, I mentioned my own sentence. Please do not copy, because if you copy 100% of from the paper, you will get similarity rate index will be high, because the like a Turnitin and Identica can identify the plagiarism. So better you have your own sentence. In this case, I mentioned that this paper present the investigation of acoustic emission technology for detecting natural cracks in slow speed shaft, and what method is used to solve the problem. I get the information from the paper that acoustic emission measurement method, and what were the main finding of this paper. I also have own sentence, do not copy from the author's sentence. I have on sentence is some acoustic emission parameters, for example counts, amplitude, and ASL are reliable and sensitive in detection of natural crack on slow speed shaft. Okay, and also what information you can collect, you can asking yourself, how does the solution or result compare or contrast with the previous result? So you have to answer this question. This paper is the first known attempt at correlating acoustic emission parameters and natural defect generation in slow speed rotating shaft, and the previous publication is concerned in high speed rotational speed. So you need to find what solution or what result does the papers offers. And if you think that the author mentioned about the future works, you also have to mention here. But if none, you just take a not available, because I don't find any recommendation or future work for the paper from the authors. And last is, what is the relevant of the work to your current research? What is the relevant of this paper, the public paper, with your research, current research? So you can write down also your own sentence. That in my case last time I wrote, the relevance of the work with my current research is the acoustic emission measurement and acoustic emission parameters and slow rotational speed. And the different is the object of measurement, that is slowing bearing nut shaft object. So according to this information, later on you just copy and paste whatever you have here for your introduction section. So this will be to construct your introduction, because you have already a number of the annotated bibliography from the published paper. Yeah, this is my type. Before I construct introduction, I do called annotated bibliography. Okay. This is crossed by the header, so I would like to see the tips is, you need to collaborate with others researchers overseas, or maybe also within your area. For what? The objective is to learn from expert or editor or author or reviewer. You can also use their facility for research. Maybe in another country has a equipment that you don't have in your country. Also, you can obtain the data. If currently you would like to write a paper but you don't have data, you can have collaboration, and maybe your colleagues will share their data, and then you can analyze, make a paper according to their data. Also, in funding, you will be able to submit a funding if you have a wide or broad collaboration with other researchers, and also you can write together. So this is the tricks also. This is myself information, that the papers that come that has only one affiliation will have like less acceptance probability than the paper that consists of more than two or more than three affiliation. So this is, yeah, I can say like this because I have received also this experience during my experience as a writer, as well as when I become reviewer. I feel that the paper that coming only one country, I don't think that they already like a proof reader, or they have some like mix or improve in terms of analysis, as well as in terms of the language. So I would prefer that the paper supposed to have more than two or three affiliation or collaboration, so it will be increase your probability acceptance. And I think this is also You know already the journal paper type. I would like, yeah, just you have a research article, short communication, letter to the editor, perspective, and mini review. I would, and also you have a kind of the paper here, journal paper, specialized or broad interest, theoretical versus applied, full length paper versus letter or communication. Yeah, so the full length has a contra with letter or communication here. And also subscription and open access journal. I would like to say that you need also to find proper journal, because if your paper is about the specialized in particular topics or research, but you submitted to the broad journals, there will be like have some rejection rate. Or for example, your paper is about theoretically, but you submit to the applied journal, I think the review editor will have rejection point of view, because it's not suitable for the journal. So this is a trick also. You need to be familiar with the different paper type or journal type, as well as the different journal submission topics. And also, if you have enough full length paper, then you can submit to the full length. As I mentioned before, if you have now enough discussion, analysis, as well as the pages, but you think that your idea is quite new and give them contribution, you can submit to the communication or the letter. And also, if you have funding, I would suggest that you can publish your paper in open access, because it can be more useful to others, because open access journal can be open by anyone in the world without any subscription. Yeah. This my okay. And also, you can also if you would like to see, you say some journal has average acceptance time. They usually available in the website or in the paper front page of the paper. If you see, some of the journal provide this information. In a fresh, they can the journal from the submission to the acceptance, for example, like 3 months or 6 months, you can have a look as well. If you you can maybe if you like to get published soon, you need to consider about this information. But if you have flexible time, no, don't have like a target when your paper has to be published, you can just submit to any journal without this consideration. And also journal reputation, also Dorita mentioned before that the ads index of the or the yeah, papers sometimes not reflected the quality of the journals, because some journals very specific is very good, because the player and the researcher is play with in this area is very few, so the citation very less, then the impact factor will be less. But actually this journal is very good, so it's in my opinion, do not rely on journal reputation. You can as long as your paper can publish in the target, you can also be get some benefit later on. And I think I will be going to finish my PPT soon, but I would like to highlight that as a researchers, we also have to think about this. We have to avoid the misconduct. So for example, some of them misconduct is falsifying data, fabricating data, plagiarism or self-plagiarism, multiple journal paper submissions, image reproduction in subscribed journal, authorship, interpretation, and duplicate publication. So I will explain about this three later on, but maybe this one first. This is something that we need to avoid, that you don't have to, I would suggest that do not submit one paper in several journals. And also, if you would like to reproduce image from other journals, if open access, okay, because they mentioned that open access journal can we can reproduce the figures and table from the open access journal. But for the subscribed journal, you need to be careful. You need to apply like a permission or copyright permission for the journals, because in some journals will request about this. If you take one figure from the previous paper to publish in a particular journal, you have to submit the copyright permission form to the journal, and your paper will be processed. And also authorship, interpretation, and duplicate publication. And fabrication here is about making up result and recording them as if they were real. So please do not avoid about these two. Very important. If you have a result, just present as it is. Do not make up your result. Also, do not recording them as if they were real. For example, you have conducted the experiment only 6 months, but you mentioned maybe more than 6 months. So I think this will be something like include in fabrication. And number two, falsification is about manipulating research materials, equipments or processes, or changing, omitting or suppressing data or result without justification. So this is something also avoid in the our papers. So do not manipulate the research materials, just present as it is, although you have a very unsuccessful result in your experiment. You can just explain at least, and if you find the reason why the research is something like this, this is something that can give contribution to the research to the research area, because maybe they haven't done so far about your specific variables or specific experiment. But since you have an unsuccessful result, you can just present as it is, but you need to find the reason, or you need to describe, or you need to justify what happened with your result, why it looks like this, and then it's not similar to the targeted result. And I think plagiarism also is important, is using of other people's work or an ideas without giving proper credit. So the original source, thus violating the rights of the original authors to their intellectual outputs. Yes, I think thank you very much for your attention for the 1 hour plus. And I would like to return time to the moderator. And also, if you have any question, I ask and answer. Answer it. But if I have no idea at the moment, you can drop an email to me, and we can answer it later on. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Dr. Wahyu Kaisarendra, for your great presentations. We received 3 questions in the Q&A.
Okay.
First is from Mr. Jody Hidayat.
Yeah.
Would you like to share your experience to us how to become a good writer?
Okay, so I need to ask one by one, right? Okay. Mm-hmm. From Judy, I can also read your question from Judy Hidayat is how to.
Yeah.
How to be a good writer?
Yes, how to become a good writer?
How to become a good
main
writer?
Main questions, yes.
Okay. The main question is, good writer is. Actually, I think I already give some of the quote here. The first thing, that if you would like to be a good commentator, you need to become football player. So if you would like to be a writer, you have to start to write your paper soon, because you will learn all the knowledge information in practice. But if you just have some idea to be a good writer before you start your writing, that's nonsense. I think, just like have a dream. If you would like to be a good writer, you have to start. And also, I think a good tips is for me as well. Please be a reviewer as soon as possible. Although you are beginner of the authors, and you feel that I'm not confident enough as a reviewer, please just accept if any invitation to you, because you will have some opinion, point of view. You will have a reviewer point of view, because your paper will be assessed by reviewer later on. Why not you get some information or get some knowledge from being a reviewer? So if you have a chance to be reviewers, please accept it as soon as possible, because you will know how the people's paper, and then you will have some own justification. So I think this will be related to your own style on writing a papers. Yeah.
Yes, I agree with you, Dr. Kaisar.
Yeah.
Becoming a reviewer can make improve our knowledge and also receive update new update of technology, right? So we can learn what other authors already wrote or already researched, right?
Yes, absolutely. Yeah.
Yeah, that's why I also like to be a reviewer. Okay. The second questions, I think the committee, Mas Hamid or Mas Robi will answer. Yes, I think Dr. Kaisar will send the material to us.
Yes.
So we will distribute or circulate to the attendees.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you. So the third is from Mas Hamid. Yeah. The first question, how many papers you read at least to write one journal article, and how you consider reference from top journal or high reputable journal? And the second, is it enough for using application for correcting the English paper writing, or we still need to send to the proofreader? Thank you.
Okay, yeah, I try to answer one by one. Question number one is how many papers you read at least to write one journal article. Okay, the first question is this. I think yeah, we have three types of the journal paper, right? Article, review, and communication. I think this is the one that number one, article. Usually, in reference, if I'm not mistaken, I read about 30 papers to 60 papers for one journal article. But not of them is included in my reference. Yeah. Maybe I only take like about 60% of my overall papers that I have read to be included to the references section. So yeah, about I repeat again, about 30 to 60 papers I read, but maybe the first references about 20 to 40 papers for station. And how you consider reference from top journal or high reputable journal? How you consider? Okay. Usually for top journal, the citation also must be coming from the top journal. Yeah, this is also tip for you. If you would like to target to the high or top journal, you must include your reference or citation from top journals. Mm-hmm. Avoid like from like a website, also conference paper. Mm-hmm. But if you also no chance, because maybe for example, you can also only find the good information in the conference paper, it's okay. But try to like 70 or 60 to 70% of your references is coming from the journal article. I think yeah. And also my tip is if you would like to submit to the journal A, my tips also, my tricks is you have to recite it this journal. That's, yeah, for example, you submit to the like the one that I would like to submit measurement. So at least you have like a two or three papers already published in measurement journal, then it's something this is also will give some editors recommendation, because the first door of your papers will be in editor. If only check to few of them, only the scope of the paper, and then just go quickly thoroughly, not just quickly to your paper, and then once the editor okay, they will send to the academic editor. So I have been become this role as an editor as well, and also as academic editor. Academic editor role is a bit more detailed. They have to read in detail of the papers, find the reviewers, as well as the getting back the feedback, and then this is the academic editor. Yeah. And number two, is it enough for using application for correcting the English paper writing such as Grammarly, or we still need to send to the professional proofreader? It depends. If you have used Grammarly and I submit to the journals, if they don't have any comments about the your English, that's fine. I think you can just publish as it is. But if a reviewer or editor recommend you to find the professional readers, I think no choice, because they will reconsider your paper after major revision, once you have done the proofreading process. Yeah, I think this is the hopefully answer your question.
Yes, Okay, thank you. Yeah, and also I think it depends on the requirement of the journal.
Yep. Yes.
Yeah, if the journal require you send proofreader professionals, yeah,
yes.
I think we have to follow, right?
Yes. Yeah. Correct. Definitely.
Yeah. Oh, okay. The move to the next questions from Mr. Ahmad Syahrul Hoir. How to make a good paraphrase so that it is not considered plagiarism?
Okay. Yes. This is a very, very good question, I think, because this is the key of our sentence. Okay. I would like to open maybe my example of the annotated bibliography. Yes, this is that. Yeah, the good tips, the good things to find a press is to change the sentence type. For example, the paper is presented in the passive voice or active voice. Then you have to rewrite in the different tenses or form. Yeah, that's why in this slide I give two options. You can write in term of active and passive. But if you find that the paper is written in the active, then you need to change. Or if you would like to make it uniform, for example, you would like to make it active, you know, choice, you can just maybe adding something, for example, the object, for example, this is need some example. I have done this before, but I don't bring the example today. Maybe we can, if you can drop an email, I will give you some example, because I give also this tutorial or this in another Scopus or writing clinic or presentation. I have some of the example. The thing is, yeah, you have to transform the tenses and adding some information. That's it.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you, Mas Kaiser.
Yeah.
Any others wants to ask? Or maybe Dr. Hari, Prof. Isnu, do you want to add something? I think there. I checked. There are no other questions in here. Oh yeah, yeah. Mas Robi, please.
Yes. Yeah. Yeah, yes. Okay, yeah, thank you, Pak Ahmad. Yeah. Overall, I have done normal papers, long papers, but also recently, I think that because of I supervised a lot of colleagues from Indonesia, and if you followed my PPT in presentation, in PPT I also mentioned about communication. I think this is the one that you refer to. Communication is very short. It's like a 5 to 10 pages long in page, yeah. And then the information is not too comprehensive, it's not too complete. Yeah, your question is, I can answer is if you think that your idea is very new, instead of you waiting your result to be complete paper, because I believe that some of the researcher might be doing the same thing with you. So why you not starting the publish your paper as a communication paper? This means that this is only to indicate that you are the first people or the first person researcher that discussing or about and studying about this topic. So in my suggestion is, if you would like to just like a start to inform others that you have this information, this topic idea, we can start with the communication papers. The viewer will understand if in your paper that you don't have like a solid discussion, result analysis, they will understand. They will little bit decrease their assessment, and they understand. They also understand if I receive the communication, I will not too strict to give a comment. Just focus on the what idea they are present to the paper. So I think you can try to. I can help yourself because I have also recently have some of the communication papers that only like 5 to 10 pages only, and still accepted in the Q1 papers. Although the maybe the discussion, the data also not too complete as the research paper, but they still consider for publication because they think that our paper is give some contribution to the particular area. Yeah, hopefully this is answering your question. Yeah, okay. Yes, yes, sure, please. Yep. Yes. Correct. Yes. Yes. Okay, I'm trying to summary your question. So you have one paper, for example, yeah, that has long pages, right? Okay, and then you would like to have another paper with shorter. Oh, okay, yeah, okay, but they are related, each other. Yeah. This is the one that I mentioned that if you would like to be a first people in this area because maybe have not been done before, so you can start with the short, just propose your idea without experimental, also okay, without any comprehensive result. But you can also put some future works information on your paper. They will give readers and will give a review that your short paper will be continue along the time, and it's possibility that you have another publication. So I think this is okay. This is what also I have done before. Just present the way the method I would like to propose. And what improvement you would like to make, and then give some, but you need also to give some result, although not complete, not detailed, just to prove that your proposed method will be successfully give the results. And then you can cite this, this not self-plagiarism because this is something that relevant. Self-plagiarism means you have, for example, CNN, deep learning. Also, in my case, also have product design. If my paper deep learning cited my paper in product design, this is self plagiarism consideration. But if you if in your case is different because your case you start this paper long short paper, then you continue the study and it produce bigger result and bigger complete result, and this you have to relate. You have to cite your previous paper with in the short paper, then you have to explain in your new paper that this actually is a continuation or the improvement from our previous papers. Yeah, this is the good question. This is also need to thank you very much. Yeah, you're welcome.
We receive another two questions. From your from Mr. Purwono Hendradi, from your presentations, the literature review paper is important experience for beginner paper writer, but the challenge is access to journal database. How your comment about it?
Okay, I just go jump to the journal database. Maybe it is the case that you cannot access the journal, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
So I guess so.
Yeah. So I think I understand that some of the university don't have access to the subscribe journal. That's why I also mentioned in another slide that you need to have collaboration. In another, I didn't mention, but in another objective for the collaboration is you can also have access. You can ask your collaborators overseas to have downloaded your paper of interest. Then you can. Because if you find one paper very good, if you read the title and abstract, I think that you need to read the full paper. Then no way that there is no way that you have to get this paper. Maybe by your collaboration network.
Yeah, I think join collaboration
It's important.
I think so. So find another co-author that have a journal database.
Yeah.
So can help you to obtain
the paper. Yeah.
Papers. Yeah. Okay. Now we move to the next questions. Is it better to include all the data and results in the appendix of the article to make it clear, or just mention general results so that the next researchers ask questions and are interested in developing our research?
Okay.
So what do you think?
Yeah, thank you, Mr. Hamid. I think I need time to get some answer. Yeah, I also have paper about this before. Some data we cannot, because the very huge data, we cannot present all of them in the research and discussion, but try to summarize this huge data. I think the one that I just recently supervised from the PT Indonesia Power, they have very, very huge data. They have huge data in the power plant. And what we did is we try to get some information and present in the result and discussion, give some description. But if you think that this figure needs information, you can put in appendix. Yeah, this thing. Because for example, like a pressure, temperature, you need to present, right? Today, next month, next year, you need to, but in table format. If you think that this important to reader for information, for their knowledge, you need to also include in the appendix. But of course, you need also to present it first in the research and discussion, and then you can mention that a complete data set is presented in Appendix A or Appendix B. So this the hopefully answer in one the first question, and you have two questions, right? Just mention it.
Okay.
Yes. Just mention the last set so that the next session ask question and are interested. Yeah. This one I'm a bit confused. Well, what is your
I think he asked just mention general result, not in detail. I think so. I think what he wanted to ask you like that, right?
Okay.
I think Hamid is Nur Hamid.
If,
is that
if Hamid here, maybe you can also help me to understand your question.
Hello,
it's okay.
Mas Hamid. Hamid, is that you, Nur Hamid? Mas Nur Hamid? Okay. Yeah, I guess so.
I try to answer it. IMAX answered that unit still have to present in detail as possible, because yeah, I think I get some relevant. If you present your paper as detailed as possible, you will get higher citation because the people will interest with your paper. For us, I think as a researcher, not yeah. But if you would like to contact you, also the in reviewing process, a reviewer will prefer that the paper will describe detail so that the reviewer can understand what is the paper talk about. If you just keep some information, they will make us still ask is okay. But if they have a bad mood because they are busy, then they can just reject it. That means that you need to, for in my case, you try to make it clear in your discussion. Or yeah, then they will be helpful for your acceptance rates as well as citation rate in the future. Hopefully this answering your question.
Yeah, and he asked another question.
Okay.
Side, how about if the result is not too significant?
Yeah, this is the one that I mentioned before. Yeah, that's the same thing with the last I also attended Dr. Mardika Pratama. Yeah, IMAX said also as a researcher, IMAX, I also have some of the unsuccessful results. What I did is I tried to get first until maximum, change the parameters, everything. But if the result still not getting better, and you think that this is good information to others, you can also publish as communication. Because communication papers is indicating that you have to communicate, you have a paper that have to be communicated with all the peer review people. So you can submit in the communication types of the paper if your result is not so significant. But you need to, again, you need to have some good or scientific reason or measurable reason or for your why is that. Then the people maybe in the future when read your paper will not do the same thing, because if they do the same thing, or do the select the same parameters, they will get same result with you. So this is also better good information for them that according to your paper, they might avoid whatever you done in your paper, then they can select another optimal parameters. Then the paper will be also cited that they mentioned that this paper message. Okay, I think that's the thing that my suggestion.
Yes. And I think also you have to make the reviewer or editorial to make attractive to
yes.
what you are still going. I mean, in the process of resources, your result is
yes.
not significant like Dr.
Yeah.
Kaiser
yeah.
says.
Yeah.
Maybe you have a problems in conducting research.
Oh, yes.
And
sorry,
it takes time. That's yep. why. Try to make the editorial.
Correct. Yeah, I just like to add. Yeah, thank you, Dr. Kunanasi, that remind me. So you also in the paper, commission paper, you need also to mention that your limitation, so they will understand. Oh, you get this result because of you have limitation in terms of, for example, like accuracy of the measurement result, measurement sensors. Then it give you like, for example, in advanced sensor that give you like a 0.001 accuracy in your sensor, it only like 0.001 accuracy. They will understand. Oh, okay, so this result must be coming only not only the for the variable selection, also the experimental setup and sensors. This is usable. Yeah, thank you, Dr. Kunianingsi.
Yes, thank you very much. I think we already received. You already received answer so many questions.
Yeah.
And then time is almost up. Okay. Maybe Prof. Vishnu or Dr. Hari, do you want to say something?
Okay. Bu. Thank you so much, Bu Nia. I have a question for Dr. Kaiser.
Yes, please.
So we are so fortunate to have Dr. Kaiser yes. today because he has several experience as editor-in-chief also reviewers, yeah, peer review. And I'm just wondering whether Dr. Kaiser have suggestion for our attendees here, because some of them are doctoral students, and also some of them are willing to pursue their PhD programs.
Okay.
The first one is, do you have any tips, yeah, or strategy how to begin and then write also the preliminary study? Yes. And then I think one of the challenges of the student, they are thinking about waiting, yeah, waiting until they come to a milestone, and then they feel more confident to share the result. Maybe you have any suggestion for them, and then how to make a strategy to regularly present or write their research results in regular time. Yeah.
Okay, yeah.
I think that's that's my thoughts about yes. About the writing for a graduate student. Thank
okay,
you.
Yeah. 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 Pak Hari, thank you for the question. Okay, I'll try to also extract your question. So number one is how the PhD student can have idea, right, or confidence.
Yes. To write their.
Yeah. Okay.
Writing. Based on their research basis. Yeah.
Yeah. So as yeah, I assume that your question is the PhD student already get the idea, right? So they just the way that they don't have enough confidence to start the writing. In my experience last time, I also start from bachelor degree without never experience in writing, and then go to the Korea with very strict professor with how to write a paper without any guidance. The one that I did is I try to write down one sentence by one sentence. This is the one that, because your confidence level is not you cannot get the confidence level as immediately. Mm-hmm. So you need to construct from the low level, medium level, and to the advanced. So the one that I did last time is the I also already mentioned here to highlight, but the highlight means I write down the idea, not only the highlight. So I write down the idea, and then try to represent the sentence from your own point of view. Of course, in the beginning will be looks like a bit messy, but it's okay. You will have some iteration to read, and later on, if you have one complete sentence that looks nice to read, then you will have confidence. So then try to relate this sentence using the maybe conjunction, because the good papers is the information that have very flow. So try to relate with the first thing that you need to train is you have to make a complete sentence with very nice structure. And the second thing is you need to have a conjunction skill or conjunction experience. You need to relate one sentence to one sentence, and then one sentence to two sentence to another sentence. Okay, this is I did last time. Once you have this experience or confidence, then try to connect one paragraph to another paragraph.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, read again. If you think that your paragraph number one and paragraph number two still not linked, you have to find how to link this, because you will feel sometime that if you already know it. And once you have the connectivity for paragraph, you will feel that you can also connect to one section to another section. Mm-hmm. So this is then finally you will have some. But in this case, you can just learning by doing. I mean, you have try to also track that paper. You have a draft, and then you start this tips start away to the your draft.
Just don't hesitate to write.
Start immediately.
Immediately. Okay. Thank you so much.
You're welcome, Hari.
Okay. Maybe Prof. Isnu, do you want to say something?
Yes. Thank you, Mas Dr. Wahyu Kaisarendra.
Yes, Prof.
Your presentation is very nice and very detailed. So that maybe especially for the student, we can learn from the beginning. So yeah, you showed in your presentation and step by step, and I think is for me, for example, is I got some many additional experience. So that maybe can I, for example, recycle your PPT, and then maybe, and also can we share your PPT to the, especially for the student? I think
yes, Prof. Can,
experience.
Yes, Prof. That,
and as you mentioned before, we already invite, for example, Professor Akinori and Mas Dr.
Mardika,
and then now Mas Dr. Wahyu Caisyarendra. I think the student will get many angle from the many perspective, so that maybe, and then student have some confidence to try. Because the important is to try how to write, and then maybe we can become like Dr. Wahyu Kaisarendra and so on. Okay, this is my additional
Prof,
comment.
Thank you very much.
Thank you again, Prof.
Yeah, Prof.
Wahyu,
yeah,
about your contribution and your sharing.
Yeah. Okay, thank you very much. So please give applause to our speaker today.
Thank you.
We still have another event of Dr. Wahyu on 17 April. So Mas Robi or Mas Hamid or Mas Santi, could you please share the link in the chat box? Dr. Wahyu Kaisarenda will talk on deep learning and machine learning, right? On 17 April, yes.
Yes.
So he will talk about his research. So please, participant, we invite you to join in our next sessions. Our committee, Mas Robi or Mbak Santi or Mas Hamid, will share the link so you can register it now. Okay, thank you very much.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you,
Prof.
Thank you.
Warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Assalamualaikum. I will send to WhatsApp ya, Mbak Nia.
Okay. Yeah, I will send it to Mas Robi, so he will distribute your presentations. Yeah. Okay. Have a good weekend.
Bye.
Thank you.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
In live, ya.
Ya.
Foto, tak ada foto.
Oh, foto.
Tidak tadi.
Foto seluruh ini dengan partisipan.
I will send you the first group photo. Oh, now we will take a group photo again.
Okay.
Mas Robi. No, Mas Hamid.
Okay. Okay, I will wait a minute.
Jempolnya mana jempol?
Okay, 1, 2, 3 and smile. Okay, one more. 1, 2, 3 and smile. Okay, thank you.
Yes. Okay, have a lovely
thank you.
Weekend. Bye.
Bye. Terima kasih.
Terima kasih, Prof. Pak Hari.
Ya, Pak Hari. Terima kasih, Mbak.